Welcome to the third lesson. In this lesson, you learn about six kinds of frame elements. The first one is BDY, which is short for body. It's simply the body of the object. If you don't give an object a body, it cannot hit or interact with other objects. Kind is always zero for characters, attack and weapon. X, Y, width and height. These four numbers will define a body. X, Y are the coordinates of the top left corner. Along with the height and width, it will form a whole rectangle. Now you don't need to know any of that because you can just drag and drop and these four numbers will automatically change. The second frame element is B point, which is short for blood point. X and Y are the coordinates of the point where a red blood stain appears if the character is below 25% HP. Again, you can just drag and drop. The third frame element is C point, which is short for catch point. It's used in catching or being caught frames. This is pretty complicated and I won't bother explaining it, but I'll leave a link in the description. Now to be honest, you don't need to go too deep about C point unless you are making some specific skills involving catching. The fourth frame element is W point, which is short for weapon point. X and Y are the holding coordinates, which is where the character holds the weapon. Kind is almost always 1. If you want the character to drop the weapon, use kind 3. Weapon act is the frame of the weapon should be used. In weapon 0.dat, which is the baseball bat, frame 20 to 35 are the frames that the weapon is on hand. You can use any of these frames for W point. Attacking is basically the damage of the weapon. It activates the entry in weapon strength list. In the weapon file, 0 means no damage, 1 and 2 will deal 40 damage, 3 and 4 will deal 50 damage. DVX, Y and Z are how far the weapon travels when you throw it. Now it's time for the most important part, O point and ITR. Please pay attention. The fifth frame element is O point, which is object point. It is used to spawn an object. We've already discussed what an object is in lesson 0. If you forgot, please check it back. We mostly use kind 1 for O point, don't pay attention to it much. X and Y are the coordinates of the point we spawn the object. OID is the ID of the object. All object IDs can be found in data.txt. Facing is how many objects you want to spawn. I have a list here. Notice that you cannot spawn objects to both the front and the back. You have to separate it into two frames. One frame spawns to the front and one frame spawns to the back. DVX and DVY are the initial movement that you can set for the object when spawns out. But normally we write 0 because the movement of the object is written in the object file already. Action is the frame that the object should begin with. Here Firen spawns an object with ID 210, which is the fireball. The fireball will begin at frame 0. Then it will go to frame 1, frame 2 and so on. That's all for O point. I just want to remind you that O point doesn't work on first frame. We talked about that in the last lesson. The sixth and final frame element is ITR, which is short for interaction. Now there are lots of things to study, so I'll go through it slowly. Kind. Again, there are a million kinds you can use. Each has a different meaning. Combined with effect, it can create lots of cool interaction. But we'll just skip all of that. X, Y, W, H. We talked about this a lot, right? The area of effect. Drag and drop. DVX, DVY. This number set how far the character should fly when he's hit by this ITR. A rest and V rest. If you want to hit a single enemy, use A rest. If you want to hit multiple enemies, use V rest. The number in these tags are how long the object must wait before hitting the character again, measured in time units. I'll show an example from my character, the knight. This is his big ball. If I set this V rest to 5, which is very short, the ball can hit enemies multiple times. But if I set this to 70, it can only hit the enemies once. 4 determines how a character reacts to this ITR by cringing, getting into dance of pain or falling. It's very complicated, but you just need to know some basic numbers in this image. Not 100% correct, but it's suitable for beginners. I suggest you to go to David's normal punch frames, which are from 60 to 68. At frame 61 and 66, there are some ITRs. Try using form with these values and see what happens. B defense determines whether a character can block the attack or he will go to the broken defense frames. I have another image here and again. Try using B defense with different values to see what happens. I won't do everything for you, you have to test it yourself. Injury is simply how much damage the interaction deals. Z width, This is optional. If you want your ITR to influence a larger area along the z-axis, use z-width. Please note that if you write z-width 20, it will hit everything 20 pixels up the z-axis and 20 pixels down the z-axis, which makes it 40 pixels wide. So that concludes all frame elements. With everything you have learned, you can create many great skills now. This is Fire's Blow Fire skill. There's an old point at frame 271. I can simply change this facing to 50 and it will look much cooler now. Now I want you to practice making this skill. Answers are in the description. I'll see you in the next lesson.